Kingdom blessings. I'm Pastor Sheila. Are you ready to be blessed, revived, and refreshed? Well, it's time for Moed Sharana, the appointed time of refreshing. Come on, let's prepare our hearts and our minds for the Word of God. Moed Sharana. Moed Sharaga, the appointed time of refreshing. It's time for the word of God. Time to be blessed and refreshed. For in the presence of the Lord is fullness of joy, 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 joy. At his right hand, pleasures forevermore, Moed Sharaga. Moed Sharaga. Moed Sharaga. The appointed time of refreshing. I want to live in the presence of the Lord, where there's liberty. That's where I want to be. I'm going to hide his word deep down in my heart, so that I will not sin against him. Man cannot live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Da 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 ba ba da ba da ba da ba ba da da. Come on, let's go. The word of the Lord is coming from Psalm 9, verses 1 and 2. I'm reading from the Life Application Study Bible. It says, I will thank you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all the marvelous things you have done. I will be filled with joy because of you. I will sing praises to your name, O Most High. Hallelujah. And the note says, praise is expressing to God our appreciation and understanding of his worth. It is saying thank you for each aspect of his divine nature. Our inward attitude becomes outward expression. When we praise God, we help ourselves by expanding our awareness of who he is. In each psalm you read, look for an attribute or characteristic of God for which you can thank him. My dearly beloveds, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, I want to remind you today that we ought to give God praise. We ought to thank him. The psalmist says here that I will, not I might, I will thank you, not half-heartedly, but with all my heart, with all my emotions, with everything within me, with all my strength. I will praise you, Lord, with everything I have, with all my heart. I will tell of all the marvelous things you've done. God has done some marvelous things in our lives, things that are outstanding and just so awesome that we almost have to look again to make sure, like, God, you really did this? Some of you have some awesome testimonies. But here, David says that, I will tell of all the marvelous things you have done. And then it says, I will be filled with joy because of you. Because of who? Because of God. Because of everything that he has done, he makes me glad. And it says, I will sing praises to your name, O Most High. Now we know that he is the greatest and we ought to sing praises. Not only shall we sing praises, but we will open up our mouths and give him praise and glory. I admonish you, son of God, to give God glory. Give him glory. Give him accolades because he has done great things for us, whereof we are glad. The scripture said, now let Israel say, if it had not been the Lord on our side, where would we be? Where would you be now if God had left you? If he didn't bring you through, if he didn't heal your body, if he didn't provide for you, if he didn't keep you in your right mind, oh my gosh, what would we do if we didn't have God? Where would we be if he were not on our side? So again, I reiterate, I will thank you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all the marvelous things you have done. I will be filled with joy because of you. I will sing praises to your name, O Most High. So I invite you, come on, let's sing praises unto him. Let's declare his glory. Let's declare his goodness. Let's declare the marvelous things that he's done in our lives. Again, I invite you to type in on the chat and say, God has done da 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 da. Whatever he's done, give him the glory. Because marvelous things he's done in our lives. I'm glad about it. How about you? I will thank the Lord with all my heart. All my might, all my strength, I will give him praise all my days. I will tell of all the marvelous things you have done. I will be filled with joy because of you. And I will sing praises to your holy name, O Most High. Hallelujah. Glory to your holy name. I give you praise for every wonderful thing you've done in my life, in my home, in my life. Great things you have done, whereof I'm glad. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Father, we come before you, giving you glory, honor, and praise, thanking you for you have been so good to us, God. Thank you. I want to say thank you personally, Father, for all that you've done in my life, the ways you've made, how you've been merciful, gracious, and faithful every day, morning by morning. New mercies I see, all that I've needed, your hand has provided. You have given me more than enough, and I thank you. I give you glory, honor, and praise. I pray for every son of God, And God, we repent. We say, have mercy upon us, Lord, if we have neglected to give you praise, if we neglected to tell of your goodness. Father, forgive us. Forgive us for doubt, for fear, for unbelief. God, help our unbelief. We just thank you. We give you glory, honor, and praise, Lord God. And we say yes to your will, yes to your way. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth and in our lives, Lord, as it is in heaven. Father, we crown you as Lord. Hallelujah, of our lives, Lord. You are Lord. You are sovereign. We surrender to you. We submit to you. And because you are our King. Hallelujah. We are the kingdom of God, and we bring the kingdom of heaven everywhere we go. Lord God, we thank you that everywhere we go, we change atmospheres. God, we thank you that greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. God, thank you for the dunamis power you have gifted us with. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that lives inside of us. Holy Spirit, teach us and guide us and lead us in a plain path. Father, we cry out to you and we say, your will be done in our lives, your will. Father, I thank you for making your will crystal clear to us, for we hear your voice and we will follow you. God, we do love you. We appreciate you. We appreciate and we thank you so very much for loving us, Lord. Even while we were yet sinners, you sent your son to die for us. And God, we thank you. You knew we would mess up from time to time, but God, you're still merciful. You're still gracious. So forgive us, Lord. You are the potter. We are clay in your hands. Mold us, make us, shape us, break us. Take out every mar and blemish, every stain, every wrinkle. Take it out of us, for it is our desire to please you, to make you proud. God, we want to be ambassadors that are legit. Ambassadors that will show forth your praises and show forth your glory here on the earth. So shine through us, Holy Spirit. Shine through us and give us the strength. Holy Spirit, synchronize our hearts and our minds with the Lord so that we could walk in tandem according to his will and his word and his purpose. God, we thank you that we will fulfill every purpose and plan and that part of the destiny that you have for us. God, we thank you for making the vision clear that you've given unto us. We give you glory for covenant relationships, God. We thank you for our children. We thank you for our spouses. We thank you for our ministries. We thank you for the businesses that you've given us, Father. We thank you for increase. Well, we give you glory. We declare and we decree increase in our ministries and in our businesses. Not for our glory, but for your glory, that you will get the glory out of our lives and out of everything we do. Father, we want to worship you with our lives, not only in a song, but with our lives. May our entire life be worship to you, Lord, as we do everything wholeheartedly as unto the Lord. Father, not for man's glory, but for you to get the glory. Father, we thank you that you have given us the awesome privilege of being your ambassadors here on this earth. Father, we love you. We bless you. We adore you. We bless you. We adore you. We love you for great things you have done and great things you are doing in our lives. So we say yes to your will, yes to your way, Lord God. We just bless you. We adore you. God, we lift up each and every one under the sound of my voice. I pray special blessings, Lord, that they will learn you in a more intimate way, that they will have an encounter with you in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, beloved, before I go, I want to remind you to mark your calendars. It's only 18 days, I think now, till Kabbat Encounter 2021. It's going to be a wonderful time in the Lord. It's a time where we get together and we learn more about prophetic and spontaneous worship. We talk about the worship that God is asking for in this time, in this specific season. He wants us to worship him in spirit and in truth. You could check John 4, around the 23rd and 24th verse, where God says that he's looking, the Father seeketh such to worship him in spirit and in truth. Will you be that worshiper that God is looking for? He expects worshipers. He's looking, and that is his heart's desire from the very beginning. You know, when he in the garden, he used to walk in the coolness of the day and fellowship with Adam and Eve. It's all about relationship, but we come together and we experience God's weighty presence. Oh my God, that's what kabod means. It's the Hebrew term kavod. Some people say kavod or kavod encounter. It's the weighty presence of God. And that's what we're expecting to happen November the 20th, when we all get together and worship God. We have a special guest ministry coming to bless us. And that's Associate Pastor Nancy Jackson Johnson. Listen, I am so excited about what the Lord is going to do. I know that the Lord is putting a word in her mouth, and she's going to bless us all as the Lord uses her to minister unto us. But I'm telling you, you need to go and register if you haven't registered yet. It's very simple. You could go to www.ww2wministries.com. Up in the top right, you'll see events. Click that, and then you'll see RSVP, and you can register right now. So easy. Fill out the form, and you'll be done, and you'll be ready for registration. Listen, it's going to be a little bit more at the door. So why don't you go ahead, take this time now, go to www.ww2wministries.com and register for Kabod Encounter. It's going to be right in Cranford, New Jersey at Calvary Tabernacle, 69 Myrtle Street in Cranford, New Jersey. Don't miss it. And by the way, share this information. Invite a friend. Tell them to come on along. You could even treat them. Look, it's going to be a blessed time in the Lord. I'm telling you, you don't want to miss it. Looking for you at Kabod Encounter 2021. Well, beloveds, this has been Moed Shelraga, the appointed time of refreshing. I pray that you've been blessed, revived, and refreshed in the presence of the Lord. Shalom.